What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. So today I'm doing a tutorial. I'm showing you how to do shakes on After Effects, which is pretty easy, which I'm going to show you right now. I've been wanting to do this tutorial for a while now, but obviously I couldn't because I didn't have the best PC and I couldn't record and like run After Effects at the same time. But yeah, I've got a powerful PC now, so I should be good. And yeah, so obviously you can see my screen. I've got my edit right here. Yes, I'm probably going to get copyrighted for this, but honestly, I don't care. The song is Little Mosey Notice, so if you want to check it out, go ahead. This is my beat drop over here. So this is obviously my beat drop there. So there, obviously. So right here. Basically, we're going to here. But before we do that, we need to make an adjustment layer. So you obviously right-click new adjustment layer. You come up here and put S_shake. I am using a plugin for this, so if you want to try and get the plugin, you can buy the plugin. Go ahead, you need it because that's how you do the shakes. But yeah, so after we come up here, press the little FX at the top just to disable it for now because we don't really need it yet. Then we come up here, transform. This is just like scale and also like the zoom in. But yeah, obviously my beat's here, so what I do, I come over here and press 150, click the little time thingy, whatever it is, then you click Control Shift, left arrow twice, and you click it and then click 100 again, and you do the same on the other side, so you come back on the other side, and do 100 again. So now we've got these three keyframes, and yeah, obviously, I come over to the graph editor. You right click, edit speed graph, and you should have this here. Basically what you do, you just drag this one left and pull it up. Do it like left as far as you can, so about there. Then you do the same with the other one. You bring that right and then down. And obviously you got this. And you got that. It's nice and smooth. but yeah, that's literally the zoom in. The shake is what we do. We enable the shake now. And these are the settings that I use. So for amplitude, whatever it's called, I use 10. Here I use 7. And then obviously, X shake, I leave that as it is. Y shake, I leave that as it is. The Z shake, I don't really use the tilt shake, turn that off, I don't like that. Then obviously come back up here, you press the clock thingy for where your beat drop is, and you do the same like you did with obviously zoom, control shift, arrows twice, whatever. Sorry, I'm really bad at tutorials. Okay, so yeah, you go that way, left, then you go right again, pull that zero, and click U on our keyboard, then we go to graph editor again, we should have the same thing that we did the zoom, we do the exact same thing. But we use the middle ones as well, so bring that down and we'll bring that up. Boom. I'm gonna drag that out a bit. So this is the shake. But it's not smooth because we haven't put motion blur on it. So you come up here, click motion blur, and then yeah, it should be smooth. So that's the shake. Sometimes I like it to like drag out a bit, so I just get you pull it out in a sec. And then sometimes I want to like zoom before I shake, so I bring the zoom a bit more before, so it's like this. In my right car. So like that, perfect. So it's like that, perfect. And if you want to do the same thing for the other beats, you just literally copy the adjustment layer, Control C, and obviously you just Control V. And you just do the same for the other beat, you just copy paste it. In my right car, business change. I like I noticed. That was sick, that's cool. But yeah, that's pretty good. 40 in my right car, business change. Yeah, that's pretty much how you do a shake, it's pretty easy. Tell me if you want me to do like speed ramp tutorials. I will do speed ramp tutorials if you want. But yeah, let me know. That's pretty much it, that's all you have to do. That's literally how you do the shake. Obviously, if you don't want the shakes the same, like every single shake. You can literally change the shake up every time if you really want to. So maybe you could just pour, you could pour this 8 or this 20, bring this down to 20, you know what I mean? You can change it stuff. You know what I mean? You can change the shakes whatever you want, but I like it 7, I like my settings, or yeah, so, but yeah. That's pretty much how to do it. Thank you for watching. I will see you in the next tutorial, because hopefully the next video is going to be a tutorial as well, or it might be just a normal video. I have no idea. I'll decide what I'm going to make. I don't know. That's pretty much it. It's pretty easy. Speedrun tutorial coming soon, probably, if I can film some clips to speedrun, because I don't have any. But yeah, thank you for watching. I will see you in my next video, and yeah, peace. Mama told me I can make you see the brightness in her eyes. I said I don't need to fake it, got the flame, won't let it die. And I'm traveling these places trying to keep up on that ground.